So we have built this basic Bootstrap form. Now we want to add validation to this using template-driven approach. So as we explained in the last lecture, with template-driven approach, we apply a directive to our input field, and Angular will create a control object and associate it with that input field under the hood. Now guess what? You already know this directive. That is ngModel. So here on this first name input field, I'm going to apply the ngModel directive. We used this before with the two-way binding syntax, or banana in a box. Remember that? So we used it like this. Here's a box, here's a banana, and we used ngModel like this and bound this to a property or a field in our component, like first name. Now here we don't need two-way binding yet. Perhaps we can add this in the future, but all I want to show you is that when you apply the ngModel directive on an input field, in its simplest form, without any binding, Angular will create a control object and associate it with this input field under the hood. Now, let's preview this in the browser. So back in Chrome, we get this error. If ngModel is used within a form tag, either the name attribute must be set or the form control must be defined as standalone. So basically, the reason we got that error is that we didn't set a name attribute here. This is a requirement, because every time we apply this ngModel on an input field, and it needs a way to distinguish these control objects. So here we set the name attribute. I'm going to use the same value as the ID. So first name. Save. Now back in the browser, the error is gone. Now I want to show you that control object under the hood. So these two attributes are all you need to set in order to use the template-driven approach. But in this video, I want to show you what is happening under the hood. So I want to handle the change event of this input field. And here we're going to call the log method. Now I need a reference to this ngModel directive. I want to pass that reference to the log method so we can log it on the console. For that, we're going to create a template variable. So hashtag, let's call that template variable first name. You could call it anything. And as the value, I'm going to use ngModel. So when Angular sees this, it's going to set this template variable to the ngModel directive that is applied on this input field. Okay? And then we can pass this variable to our log method. So here's the log method. We pass first name. Now let's go and implement this method. So back in our component, I'm going to delete the stuff that we don't need. Let's just keep it simple. Here's the log method. Let's give it a parameter called x and simply log it on the console. This is just for diagnostics. Now back in the browser, I'm going to type my name here. Press tab. Now let's take a look at the console. Okay, here's our ngModel. So you can see ngModel is an object with these properties. Now look at this property, control. This is the control object that I was telling you about. Now if you click on the value, look, it's an instance of the form control class in Angular. Let's expand this. Here we have a bunch of properties, and many of these properties come in pairs. For example, we have this dirty, which determines if the value of the input field is changed from the moment the form was initialized. In this case, because I typed my name here, dirty is true. Now the opposite property is pristine. Pristine means clean. So dirty should be true and pristine is false. Okay? Now we have another pair, invalid and valid. In this case, because we haven't implemented validation yet, this input field is considered valid. So invalid should be false and valid should be true. Now if we have any validation errors, they're available here. Currently, errors is null because we don't have any errors. We have another pair, which is touched and untouched. In this case, because I touched the input field, or in other words, I put the focus there and then moved away, touched should be true and untouched should be false. We have another important property, value, which returns the current value in the input field. So what I want you to note here is that we use this form control class to track state changes and the validity of input fields. When we apply the ngModel directive along with the name attribute on an input field, Angular automatically creates an instance of the form control class and associates it with this input field. Now, to finish up this lecture, I'm going to apply ngModel on our text area as well and set the name attribute to comment. In the next lecture, we're going to add some validation here.